All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to look at how to invoke Aura classes from Lightning components, that is Lightning web components. So earlier in Visual Force or in Aura Lightning components, what we used to do is we used to have that controller equal to controller name, and then we used to add the method, and then the callback. Using the callback, we used to call the get the method, and then the parameters used to be passed, and we used to do a callback and execute the method. Here it's a bit different. Here basically, as I told you, you'll have to import the classes and methods into the Lightning web component. Okay, so let us see how this is done. There are two ways to connect to Apex. One is using wired attribute and one is by event click. Now what is the difference here is, if you say @wire, then all the methods which are specified with the @wire will fire. All the controller methods will fire at during initialization of the component. So it will automatically get invoked when the Lightning web component comes up. Whereas imperative means when you click on a button or related to an event, like save a data, save the record. In that case, you can use the imperative call. So let us see how to do both of this. First and foremost, you have to wire that JavaScript class to specify a wire adapter for an Apex method. And as you know, you have to make the class as @aura enabled, and then only it will be invocable. You have to say cacheable equal to true, and then it will be invocable. Okay, that method which you want to invoke, it has to be marked as @aura enabled. Now this is very similar to Aura components. Okay, so that's why I would suggest and encourage you that you please go ahead, and if you have not done the admin app builder developer course, please complete those course, because there will be some continuity. You will know what is a Visual Force page, then you will know what's an Aura component, and you will also know what we are learning now, learning Lightning web components better. The understanding will be faster and better. See, this course is good. We are assuming that you have already done the developer part of it. You know what is an Aura enabled cloud, you know what an Apex class is, alright, and also the assumption is you know a bit of Aura component development. Okay, so anyway, so let us continue with this, and let's first try the wired attribute where the Aura class and method will be called implicitly, automatically at init. So how do we do that? First, you have to import the Aura class and the method to be invoked. Now this is similar like adding the controller equal to controller name in the Visual Force tags or in the Lightning Aura component tag. Then what you do is you specifically import the whole method. You say import the method name from, you have to use the syntax as Salesforce FX class dot method name. Alright, so basically you import the static method from the class. Now this will be available to your component for use. So there is no controller equal to controller name. Earlier you used to just say controller equal to callout one, and then you used to get access to all the methods. This way you cannot do it. We have to basically import the class, and then the syntax to may fire it implicitly is you say @wire pass the method name and any parameters if any. Okay, and I'm just giving an example here. And then we'll have a callback method and which will execute the result. This is like, you know, response callback method for Aura components. When you call a method, the results will be returned back here, and then you can process it. Multiple methods can be invoked in a wire. Okay, so you can have multiple @wire. So if you want 2-3 classes methods to fire to do different different things, you can call the methods. But be careful, because it will affect your performance, because this will automatically fire when the component is initialized. So let's take a look at how to import it. We'll say make get callout from the method name and import the class. Okay. And now write the, how do we call the Apex part of it? We'll say @ make get callout, and then within curly brace, any parameters. Right now it's not accepting any parameter. And then of course this is the kind of a promise kind of a JavaScript method, HTTP call, which is calling, giving any name. You can give any name here. The result will be over here. Okay. This is the result that you'll get. So you can use the result to check for the values, and if there is an error, you can also, it will also there is a result dot error. All right, if the result dot data is true, otherwise you can use the result dot error. So let us see how to do this first. So let's head back here and go to the Apex part of it. Now I'm going to create a So I'm going to go ahead here and let's see the Apex classes in the setup. First and foremost, I'm going to build the HTTP class. So what this method does, basically I have this callout method. What this does is, it's a typical HTTP call from Salesforce. Okay, so there is an endpoint called as Heroku App Animals, which is an open API endpoint. So what this method will try to do is, it will access the method there and return the values from this URL endpoint. Okay, it is going to do a HTTP call. Let's use Chrome. Yeah, so these are the values. It's like in a map. So within that, there is a list. Okay, so the map is containing to a map to a list, Majestic Badger. So if you can, so what this is going to do is, this is going to do a normal HTTP call. Now all of this is covered in a separate developer tutorial. Okay, so here we will only see how this is invoked. Okay, now if you want to learn more about the developer, you'll have to learn the Apex development part, or you may already be aware of it. Okay, so now this is going to just a public with sharing class, and this is a static method, and this has to be marked as @AuraEnable cacheable equal to true. Okay, so the cacheable equal to true will help in some performance improvement, and you know, it will unless there are some changes in the class, it will cache the local copy of the class for some time. So if there are many users connecting to your server, so it will improve performance. Now you have a method over here. Now this method is simple HTTP request. I'm building the request here, setting the endpoint here, and doing a GET, and it's going to send the request. And what this does is, it converts the map of string and objects. So it returns a deserialized value, comes back. This value is coming back and converted into a map of string and objects. And then within that object, we get the result.getAnimals, which is a list. Alright. So, and looping through the list, basically, it does a system debug. And finally, what it is doing is, it's returning a value, response.getBody. So it returns the whole this value back. Alright, so let's first test this. And finally, what we are going to do is, we are going to call it from LWC. So let's quick save this. So always test your Apex class before you call it from Aura component or Lightning Web component. So let me go here for the test. And yes, so now let's confirm this. So the method name is callout one, and class name is callout one, and since it's a static method, I can do make get callout. So let me just do that and see if it works. So we're having an issue here. Let's see what. Again, and execute this method. So this method is going to hit the endpoint and return the value back. Alright, so if you see here, it has received the following animals: Majestic Badger, Fluffy Bunnies, Carry Bear, and Chicken. Now, one important thing you need to do is, you need to see to that, you know, you not only copy this code here into your org. Okay. Not only do you copy the code, but you also have to enable the remote site settings. See, to hit any third party URL, you have to create a remote site setting and allow that this endpoint to be accessible. If you don't create a remote site setting, your Apex class will not be able to access it. So the remote site the remote site details is available. Once you enable the remote URL, then only you'll be able to access the remote site. Okay, so that is one of the main things in Salesforce. If you don't enable the URL, your code will not work. Okay, you will not be able to access the remote endpoint. So in addition to the code, you'll also have to enable the endpoint that you're hitting for the animals. Okay, only the main endpoint you'll have to give. This one, you have to only give the main endpoint like this one. Okay, after that you can access the other parts.